Yo, what's going on, everybody, in the Telegram chat, the dungeon, as well as YouTube. I am going to post this video on YouTube. I'm coming back with a GJ breakdown. It's been a while since I did a full breakdown. And by full breakdown, I do mean breaking down from top-down analysis, support and resistance drawn live, and exactly how I analyze the market before a session, how I go about the chart before I start trading. I had a couple DMs, I had three DMs actually this week about, you know, when am I going to do a full breakdown, because a lot of people actually like me live breaking down, because then you end up seeing how I look at the market, how I look at price action, what I see, you know, how I see different candles doing what. And we're going to start off on the weekly time frame. I'm going to try to do this whole video with no edits, because editing is annoying and I just want to upload straight to YouTube. But yeah, we're going to break down GJ. We're coming off a 4% week last week, which is amazing. Best week I had since the end of July. All of August, as you guys remember, was just terrible. August was this entire month of consolidation right here. All of this. I took about 5 trades in here and it was just bad. It was bad. But that happens. It's the market. The luxury of trading is being able to work when you want, and that's why we only took like 5 trades in the month of August. If it's not there, it's not there. Don't force it, right? Oops. So when it comes down to GBP JPY this week, right, we're going to start from the weekly time frame, and we're going to mark down areas of support resistance, market structure, see what price is doing, see what price is telling us. Starting off the weekly time frame, daily time frame, 4 hour, and then maybe break down to the lower time frames. Lower time frames for me are usually how I enter. When it comes down to the weekly time frame, well, we're going to see a big area of supply and demand right here. Again, for those supply and demand areas to me, right, look at all this. Look at all these weeks to the upside. This is the weekly time frame. So when you go in the weekly time frame, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 weeks of rejection. And over here, just multiple weeks of rejection again. You know, especially coming from a higher time frame, supply and demand is, to me, a stronger support and resistance, right? It's where price has multiply and aggressively rejected. So you could trade off supply and demand areas without as many conflict influences because of how strong those levels are. When it comes down to GJ, we do have this huge supply and demand area that we have been drawing, you know, so long. This is just an area that I'm familiar with. We've been up here for months. So, you know, on the weekly time frame, I'm going to draw my support resistances and everything around it. Another area of support resistances that I see is over here, as we have multiple weeks of price failing to break under this area right here. And that's pretty much all we need. It's unnecessary to draw up your chart over here. You know, price isn't down there. Price would need to drop an absurd amount of pips to get down here, 700 pips, 650 pips, whatever. So we're not going to mark up that. Don't crowd your chart. You know, simplicity is, you know, my live stream stopped. But yeah, keep it simple, right? You want to be able to see the chart clearly, as clear as you want, as clear as you can. So down on the weekly time frame, what I'm seeing is price again at this area, rejecting multiple times and giving this big bullish engulfment, and then price actually reached this area, supply and demand area, and then it closed bearishly for the week. Very strong bearish closure, very strong rejection. I do believe on the weekly time frame, we could actually begin to start reaching down back to this area, right? Huge area, huge rejection, closed bearishly, high momentum. I do believe that we could go down to 161.120. Yeah, 161.200. At least to 161.200. But that's just a weekly time frame. You know, we're not going to base our bias too much on that, but it does give me a sense of direction of where price could go. When you go down to the daily time frame, daily time frame is very interesting because first we're going to drop an area of support resistance. We have a huge area right here. Right? We see we have an area here, an area here, area here, an area across the board right here. And now we have a newfound area of support resistance right here. So we're going to grab our zone. Grab our zone. These. So we can pinpoint. Change our color to blue. This is the daily area. And as you can see, after drawing it, price has come down to this area and perfectly found support. We have this bearish bullish variation, which means price has found support. Anything under this, I'm going short. If we begin to trade under 161.160, I'm going to go short. Why? Well, that's the newest profound, that's newest found area of support and resistance. And when you go down, and it's on the daily time frame. So when you go to the daily time frame, you know, if price were to break under, retest, give us price action to get there and go short. That's what we're going to do. Because now we have the confluence of the weekly time frame. Now the weekly time frame is in confluence with our daily. Now we can go short as long as we start to trade under this area, right? And that's the daily time frame. But this is very interesting. If we trade under the 161, 160 area, no, the 162.950, no. 163.000 area. The 163.00 area. Once we start trading under there, I'll be looking to go short. Once price falls under or the zone, as you can see, when price falls under, we just come down to the next area support resistance. To go long, we are at area support resistance. This is a daily key area, very strong area. So I actually do see bullish movement and for multiple reasons. We could potentially see bullish movement because one, we're at support resistance. Two, it's a daily bearish bullish variation. And when you look at market structure, right, we come up, make a higher high, higher low, higher high, and price breaks under that pivot point. This is a pivot point. Price breaks this point. Now we have a lower low. This low is lower than the previous low, and this is it. Because higher high, higher low, higher high, lower low. This low is lower than this low. So actually, what we could see potentially is a correction of this move to the downside right here. Because we're at a lower low. And usually, if you're going to continue going short, you're going to create a lower high and then continue to go low again. But it all depends on what price does here in this area. Where we're at right now is very crucial. Because if we start to break under, we're going to go short anyways. But I do see a bullish movement first to one, correct this move, and two, retest the previous low. Because that's usually what happens in market structure. Price creates a higher high, higher low, higher high, and more times than not, price is going to come back and retest the previous market structure area to then go long again. Just like here, price is going to come up, price is going to come up, come down, come up, come down, retest that previous area, just like over here, to continue going short. So for a bullish scenario, I do see it. As long as we get some price action in here, I do believe that we're going to come up to the next pivot, the previous pivot point, which is going to be 165.176. That's the daily time frame. Now we're going to go to the 4 hour, because the 4 hour also tells us a lot. The 4 hour, after we draw there is a support resistance. The 4 hour has actually given us a multiple rejection to the downside, a little higher low right here, and then we broke above. Right now, what I'm looking for actually to continue going long is for this little minor area to hold and be retested. Why? Well, because, you know, we're getting our rejection here. We rejected down here, we came up, we come right back down. We even have a minor, very minor higher low. This is on a lower time frame market structure. Right now we have a minor higher low. I do believe price can actually start going bullish. Once we break this area and go low, that's when I'll go short. But as of now, I do see price right now retesting this little mini area of consolidation to continue to go long. And that's basically what I'm looking for on GJ. I do believe that if we go long, I feel like we could correct all the way back up to 165.136. And from there, we're going to continue either going short or we just continue breaking low. That's a scenario for another day. As of right now, we're trading in this area. If we have price breaking under and retesting this area of support and resistance, we're definitely going short. And for now, one, we're going to have to wait for session. And two, I would like price to come down here, as you see, come down here, retest this area, and then continue going on at 165.136. Or actually, I like my targets to be very precise. I like this right here. I can see price going to 164.855. And that is a full breakdown of GBP, JPY. Hopefully price relaxes and doesn't take off without us. Last night we did not trade because we had a bank holiday today. We have no news for the upcoming day tomorrow, so I think we should be good. It's 9 o'clock. This 4 hour is about to close right now. And yeah, that's basically my outlook on JPY. Look at market structure and look at support resistance, supply, and demand areas. And most important, price action. What is price going to do? What price needs to do for us to go short? And what does price need to do for us to go long? Sometimes you don't always have that. Sometimes you have no long scenarios and you only have a short bias. But in this scenario, I do see price most likely or possibly no, going either way. We can continue going short and just continue this huge bearish move, or we can correct this bearish move for a short term, go long to 165.000. That's my outlook for GBPJPY. I'll see you guys later when I drop a signal possibly tonight, as long as I get a nice trade. I do believe so. I'm just happy to be back in the trending market. The month of August was terrible. Did not pay me. Because markets are shitty, just look at all of this. This is all of August. We're just in this range, right? Wiki, wiki. And not even that. It was like a wiki range. Like look at just like this wick here and then wicks here and then wick here, wick. Like these wicks are ugly. So we're back in a trending market. We traded all of this. We went long here, we went long here, we went short here, we went short again here. And that's what I got for GBP JPY. I'll see you guys later. Hopefully we break our career high, which is, I actually never had better than a 5K day. I never had better than an 8K week. So I'm looking to beat those every single day. And I hope, hopefully I do it in front of you guys. I want to break my daily record and I want to be my weekly record and just keep on breaking personal record. So I'll see you guys later. That's my breakdown of GBP JPY. Hope you guys enjoy it. Hope you guys take a lot from it. Hope you guys go over your own trading plan and figure out, what are you doing wrong? What are you doing right? How could you improve on the things you're doing right? So I'll see you guys later. Deuces.